and Sion, but not much value from the last pick there.
Honestly, if Rush isn't on a champion that he's comfortable with taking over the early game and he doesn't get early kills, I don't see what Impulse are going to try and pull off here. I mean,
yep.
Maybe they revert to a Sivir. They haven't reverted to Sivir.
They get their Azir finally, I think.
So
here.
Long. I don't think they're ever going to.
Azir or Kalista can come through. That's almost a certainty here unless Team Impulse decides to block their ability to first pick one of them for some reason. When Team Liquid was on red side last, they banned both Azir and Kalista. And even before the series, we were talking about how Team Liquid would have so much more versatility in the pick and ban phase, about how Team Impulse was fairly one-dimensional, and a lot of that is holding true right now. The fact that they then ban Azir, allowing Kalista to be banned through as well, yeah, they did not want to play Kalista.
We're going to see, or actually, well, so the...
Or Azir.
He didn't play the Evelynn when Shen was banned, when he had the option to. I think it might be a composition thing right here. We've seen the Orianna win every single time now, the Orianna-Lulu matchup these mid laners keep going back to. That's the first champion I think of maybe comes out first pick, but Maokai they banned last time. They didn't want to see that champion played again. Impact having some kind of point-and-click CC so we can follow up to make these TP plays is maybe what enables that first 20 minutes that Impulse needs so much.
Yeah, they need to find ways in order to initiate fights properly. The one game they won was because they had Evelynn Shen and they could create fights at every window. They still have Evelynn up. A home guard teleporting Maokai with the Evelynn can still provide some pressure, so it's not the worst pick.
But why would
you first
pick a Maokai? There's so many more options.
Mm-hmm.
Like even if Quast ends up taking the Maokai away, you can play Gnar into it. Impact's a great Gnar. And now this forces them to move Gate to something else that they need damage from. I guess Rush is going to... At least this may signal that Rush will take up the mantle of doing damage this time around.
Mm-hmm.
He won't go a full tank Elise.
Or even a full tank Lee Sin. I wonder if Team Liquid goes for Orianna here, or if they even care about that, whether they think the Orianna winning all three games is correlation instead of causation, because I guess it's
not
a little bit more
enough.
Causation. That's the Orianna. It's the smart choice with the Maokai being first picked. It's the only way they can create a ball delivery system. Great pick there by Team Liquid to get Orianna.
Do we see Gate move to Victor now instead?
I want to see it.
Because I don't want to see an Impulse team with the amount of damage that a Maokai Lulu. And Rush has been going fairly defensive as well, so.
Yeah, honestly, Impulse have lost a lot of Kog'Maw games in a row. They're going to go back for the Evelynn Ashe. They're going to go back for a top lane and a bot lane with a ton of gank follow-up now. Maokai targeted Root, and then a knock-up afterwards. Ashe has the nice stun. You can even force cleanse onto some of the laners so that it even makes the matchups easier.
Yeah, Rush will be bringing damage again as well.
Now, is it the Soraka or the Leona?
I hope Gate goes for Victor. I think they need the extra punch in their team comp on top of anything. And as far as Team Liquid goes, there's also the chance they can throw in Soraka on the backside. Like, that is probably what Tip should be going for. Team Liquid is the flexible team.
Very flexible.
By far. They can still pretty much go any direction they want.
Top lane Nautilus for Quas.
As soon as you see as soon as you see an Ashe pick, you look for ways to punish it early on.
Mm-hmm.
And they still have plenty of time to
Pollution's
do that.
Strong in this case.
But Braum would be my go-to to combine with him. I guess they'd rather have the hook.
At least Nautilus is flex, though. I think this is a little bit nice. They can still go Braum, and they can still go Nautilus support. I mean, Nautilus definitely does have reasonably good ways of punishing Ashe. You at least have a point and click CC.
Yeah, but then we get another matchup like Maokai Nautilus in the top lane.
Oh, we already have, I'm pretty sure.
To be fair, that is more damage in that matchup than there is in the Sion Malphite fight.
By far. There's way more. There's tons more damage, not even comparable. Quas did play Nautilus in games 3 and 4 against TSM in their semifinal series, so I'm pretty certain to say that's a top laner. It brings him a good tank threat as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it also allows X Special to decide whether he needs to play a disengage support or an engage support. I actually like, in this case, waiting last pick for your support.
Yeah.
Because
see
it can
what the comp
also,
looks like.
It can curb the composition in a pretty meaningful way.
Ooh.
Please. Do it.
Gate's
Impulse
being
needs to be able to just go
Diana.
All in here.
Gate have it in him.
He's already hovering teleport, yeah. And it's another champion that can join the rest of the team. You have four melee champions. Every single one of these champs has some way of diving in and starting a fight. Impulse, this is probably the most Impulse comp I've seen from them all split long. And now, what is going to fight the Maokai? Is it the Nautilus, or is that Flex's support?
I want to see X-Special Lugiana here. But if he's decided to go and engage support, I think we're in for a game that has more than one kill at 30 minutes. Just a bold prediction here.
Bold predictions from chat. I think we will have by far more kills than one in 30 minutes.
I want to see how this warps the mid lane, because the junglers have been staying pretty clear of the mid lane since it's constant shielding champions over and over. But with Diana, she extends very far up because she's melee. She's constantly trying to shove the wave. Gate's going to need some more attention this game if he wants to succeed, if they want him to be a piece of power for the team. Otherwise, Diana getting behind versus Orianna would be terrible for them if Dominate gets off the first gank and they're able to snowball against her.
Yeah, bringing two teleports, though, for Team Impulse creates more opportunities for aggression. They're just going to want, they need to keep the tempo up again and again. Team Liquid, though, is picking a relatively elusive team. It's going to be a relentless amount of initiation from Team Impulse, and it's going to be countered by a large amount of disengage from Team Liquid. Gragas Janna is pretty much the best disengage support jungle combo you can bring into a League of Legends game.
Yeah.
So it's initiation versus Team Liquid, who's just always looking to absorb and counter the opponent's team composition.
They've got ways to deal damage while running away. Orianna has no cast animations whatsoever, and Lucian can pop the culling while running, so certainly the ability to deal damage while doing that disengage you're talking about, Jat, is available here for Team Liquid if they can stretch Team Impulse out too far. We're going to get ourselves now heading up into Game 4. Liquid already leads the series 2-1. They could close it out right here, just like last time. 3-1 over Impulse. Take the third place. If they win here, Liquid have a 50-50 shot of auto-qualifying for the World Championship. Now, you guys at home, stay connected with us on Twitter. Let us know who's going to win this one. Of course, it's already 2-1 up for Team Liquid, but tweet hashtag TIPWin or hashtag TLWin. Do at LOL Esports. Let us know how it's going to go. We're going to update the poll in just a few minutes. You guys here in the audience have opinions. You guys at home have opinions. The analyst has opinions. Everyone's got their stake in this one. But here we go. Game 4, Liquid up 2-1. Impulse must win here to stay alive.
Yeah, the new wrinkle to Team Impulse's team composition is an aggressive pick for Gate. He has been completely pushed onto the support of mid laners, aside from the few successful Azir games he has had, but obviously Azir has been banned this entire series. So now we get to see his hand to teleport Diana. I think the game and series will really hinge on whether or not Gate can be successful and add extra damage into their die. Otherwise, Team Liquid could just control another game and walk away with the series.
Interesting that Impulse, Impact is picking a fight here. This is merely a distraction because they already have their duo up top in the brush. Impulse looking to get off the swap here. No deep wards other than the red buff to see where the jungler starts from Team Liquid during that exchange.
It looks like we will stop with the general line of scrimmage wards. I've heard people say it's the 5-point ward start. A lot of names for it. Actually, there's one deep in towards the Raptor camp. Actually, this could be an important ward for Team Liquid here. It's very common for the Maokai to throw, I believe it's 3 saplings into the camp. The mid laner throws an AoE ability, takes 3 Raptors to start of the game. Team Liquid could stymie that. And you can see Phoenix trying right here.
He wants to take it.
Yeah, Phoenix wants to be the one to get the farm out of this.
Maokai just doing that for himself.
He's not do a jungling with Rush, which is very curious.
Well, they're trying to give away the, that they're not swapping top.
How did Rush get there? This is such a nice move.
They even took all the damage. Wow, yeah. What a setup for Impulse.
That's such a good start for Rush.
It was all a mind game there, because showing Maokai top and then Maokai at Raptors. If Maokai's doing a camp by himself, that's indicative of regular lanes from Impulse. They would not expect Rush to go for a solo man invade there, but very good experience lead and gold lead for Team Impulse right off the start, taking that away from the duo lane.
We've already got interesting lane assignments as well. It's a lane swap kind of game. Ashe's top lane, Lucian's in the bot lane. Maokai was already there. Impact did the early TP, Quas teleported to go meet Ashe up in the top side. So I want to know where the supports end up going. Janna is going to support the Nautilus. Meanwhile, Leona is going to make it a 2v2 up there.
Absolutely. This is interesting. I like what Rush did as well, taking the two small camps from the blue buff just to deny Dominate even more experience. And honestly, if we're trying to analyze whose favor this is in, the Nautilus with the support can only really farm out of the turret, whereas I think Impact will be able to get a decent amount of farm off against Lucian.
Here he is, coming to try and punish the melee mid laner. Success.
This time.
That lane's in a pretty poor spot for Gate now that he's down Flash as well.
And Impact moves some damage to Piglet. Does dodge the sapling, which means Impact now is going to get a little bit afraid of some light slung at him. This wave will push down towards the Maokai, though. Impact's
going to
start a lot of potions. Much safer for Kwas here. So far, the AD carries and top laners are matching in farm, but a health lead for Team Liquid. No flash on Gate means if he pushes his wave out again, he can't meet the wave anymore. And the chance of Phoenix freezing is real.
It's really troublesome for Diana to lose control of the wave, especially that early on. We'll see how Team Liquid try and go about warding for Rush this time he's on Evelynn. Last time, they had plenty of defensive pink wards, plus they got the very deep wards at the jungle camps as well. Me a lot riskier getting in there for that this time.
Nice kill on the ward. Kwas can't track Leona, so in comes the push, but Adrian's Q is down from killing the ward.
Yep.
Yeah, just tempting to harass him a little bit. Interesting now that they think Kwas is at a point, now that he has a couple points into his E, that he can be left alone.
I mean,
instead,
the wave is pushing towards him, so yeah, he's not going to get...
He's probably totally fine. I think it's a smart roam by Team Liquid here to send a special down, get ward control for Lucian.
Leona's
and also to make sure Piglet keeps up his farm.
This is interesting. Leona's one of the very best turret divers, and I don't think they know where Rush is. Nice play, though. Team Liquid still doing plenty of damage to Impact. He's still a minute away from his teleport being back up, and now it's their turn to potentially find a dive. But Rush is waiting in the wings, hiding in the brush to the side. They will not be pushing into Impact here.
Good slow there for another Talus shot.
Yeah, it's becoming an interesting game here. How much damage can Piglet do to Impact, and how much damage can Adrian do to Kwas? Adrian Apollo do to Kwas, rather, in these swap 2v1s we have. Interestingly enough, the junglers are nowhere to be found in any of this. A lot of times you'd see them posturing to defend or do the gank, but instead they've just been power farming. We just saw Rush at a sliver of health just trying to get up his levels and get as quickly as he can to Runeglitch.
Yeah, it was a little bit too sneaky with all the counter jungling he did at the very beginning. Took a lot of damage for it.
Yeah. He still ends up 130 gold above I Will Dominate at this second in time.
And experience. So.
Yeah. So not the worst in the world, but we'll see what else gets paid forward. Overall, Liquid are actually up 100 gold from the laning phase, though, so you can't really complain on their side of things.
Well, yeah, a lot of that is the difference in Maokai and Nautilus. Great wave control from Kwas and last hitting.
Oh, Piglet gonna get stopped up though. Adrian buys a little bit of time.
There's not much follow-up at all.
Not gonna kill him, but it still does make an awkward recall. Adrian actually wants to push this wave though. He's like auto-attacking everything.
Yeah, it's a significant delay in time though, for sure. Especially, they need to be able to shove this up as quickly as possible because Piglet should be able to get an item advantage on this recall. Apollo goes back on pickaxe. And Piglet is actually having to sit in Fountain if he wants to reach BF Sword gold.
He'll have no potions, but yeah, he'll have like right BF Sword money.
Surprised he tried to go for such an early recall if he was going to have to wait in Fountain for a BF anyway.
Yeah, that is strange.
Especially with X Special on the way. Piglet probably should have stuck around a bit for one more wave.
I think if he did wait around, though, his wave would get pushed in by Apollo and
Rush
Adrian.
Rush is going to get cut off here.
And the next recall would have been
slow
worse.
Slow rotation from Phoenix.
It's often really peculiar dealing with that kind of stuff. But yeah, the wave still does get denied with him having to wait around. Piglet loses the entire minion wave under his turret.
Yeah.
And is now...
This is the point in the game where Rush wants to force a play. They have double teleport if they really need it to create a numbers advantage. And they do have six on Apollo and nearly six on Adrian. If they get six on Adrian, it is such an executable dive. They're going early anyway.
They're gonna stun up. Piglet exhaust is on. Here comes Rush. It's the Leota pulling aggro. Piglet pops the ulti. Can't get enough damage. The Rush, the kill comes in for Gatewither.
And
the Conic special. And it's a second kill coming in for Rush now.
They didn't even have to use Impact's teleport either, so they can pull off another play like that on repeat. They also burned all four summoner spells and got the 2-for-0.
Impact just made sure Kwass couldn't go. All his goal was to make sure it was a 4v2, and it was. Beautifully played by Impulse.
That was after they saw Rush the first time he was attempting to wrap through the jungle to go for that dive. He's not dissuaded. Okay, you found me the first time. Returns to the scene, and they're able to pull it off anyway.
Yeah, knowing the deck special is level 4 key here. Also, a bit of a fake out. Adrian's not sick, so Piglet was a little bit lackadaisical about trying to watch out for the arrow. Hits him in the face, and then a clean turret tank by Adrian. Takes as many hits as possible.
Oh, the heal.
Heal from Apollo is super clutch. And yeah, Dominate was not in range to stop that. Rush again executes a nice turret dive early game on Evelynn, and now we have to see if he can take over the game.
Well, you gotta feel pretty good about these guys. Nashor's Tooth Rush is gonna be the item for Gate. Dominate looks for the top lane here. Impact is out of health and mana. But thankfully for Team Impulse, he chooses to recall right now, afraid of the Gragas. There's still a really nice deep ward that could hurt Apollo here. He is holding Flash, but no heal. Adrian is tanky, but has no mobility to get away from ganks.
Gate also finding one of those kills. Pretty huge for him. Now being close to 11, he does have significant threat on him.
What's crazy is the flash that was burned never got punished. His flash is back up already. Gate's actually been able to leave his lane and kill somebody.
Dominate was just hard farming. He just returned back to the jungle. He wasn't able to make anything happen really on either side of the map.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's pretty critical as well that Gate's been able to withstand having to burn his flash early. Hasn't suffered a death. His turret is generally okay. Picking up a kill on the backside of that dive. Really, really valuable. Part of it with Phoenix bringing cleanse, couldn't necessarily push his range advantage on the Diana early.
Yeah, weirdly it's the Lucian who has a free move dash that like got hit by things. I understand not bringing cleanse himself as Piglet because he should be able to get away from arrows.
Yeah,
well, didn't dodge the first one.
Going all the way back to that fight, I really do think a lot of it was having to do with Adrian not being six yet, so he just really wasn't expecting it.
Yeah.
I mean, they did see Rush coming for it 30 seconds before.
You're completely right, Kobe. It was
thought they were
going
to wait for Adrian to hit six.
All right, Chad. Okay. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I agree with both of you guys. I think it all bundled into two kills for Team Impulse. I'm the play-by-play. I just say it as it is. All right. Lane's rematch on the top side. This time Apollo has a BF sword.
Takes him on the outside.
He's got the pink, too.
Oh, Rush spots himself. Has red buff though. This is actually an interesting fight. Dominic has first set of burst, knocks him around. TP used this time around by Impact. And the arrow lands square in his face. There is an ulti up for the Janna. Buys a lot of time. Defensive teleport by Kwass completely unnecessary. That should have been canceled.
Yeah, once they knew they were going to repel the engage, he would have been able to pick up some farm. But even so, just a lot of stuff burned because that Ash Arrow landed direct. Rush gets himself in a little bit of trouble, but the global presence of Team Impulse bails him out. And now it's special. No ult this time.
And there is one for Rush, though. The slow's used. He saves the ulti for now. Now gets a two-man slow. A big knockback comes through, and Rush gets a kill. Piglet now fighting in the turret, but gets stunned up. Beautiful by Adrian. 4-0 Impulse.
Max range Leona ult. Dead center.
He said, if it's not Rush going out and getting a bunch of kills in the early game, then Impulse. It's not Team Impulse. He's got all four of them, or he enabled all four of the kills.
And it's the relentless diving that Team Impulse is able to put out. This is the way Team Impulse knows how to play the game. They're not a standard team fighting team. They are a diving, brawling, scrapping team fighting team. They just go again and again. And that's exactly what this composition is built to do. Every single person can assist the initiation in a meaningful way. So not everyone has to be there, but they can always make a play.
What a weird road for Impulse. For the first half of the split, it was playing Sivir to enable the other guys to go make big plays. And they stopped for a while and said, you know what, we're just going to enable Kog'Maw. They go back to it again, this time it's with Ash, who's actually a little bit better at setting up these plays, I would say, in certain ways. Right back to the style that worked so well for them in the split itself, in the regular season. And now down to potentially their last playoff game, they go right back to the strategy. The Ash Leona brought back from game one. And this time around it is working. They are finding the engages.
Well, let's see if they can start controlling the dragon then. Because they have gotten two of the outer turrets already. And they'd like to start creating some extra pressure, controlling neutral objectives here.
Ooh, big shockwave on a gate though. Plenty of damage done. The Q missed though. And Phoenix almost out of mana. Might not get the damage. Oh! Just barely the tail edge of command attack. Pigment did not hit him. That was all Phoenix. Gate, hold on to flash too long. And mid lane might go down here.
Got a little bit greedy, didn't respect the full damage for Phoenix. Finally, Phoenix punishes Gate a little bit in lane, and the turret being down as well is a great way for Team Liquid to start clawing back in this game.
So gets some XP. Adrian shows up in the mid lane. Was nearly in range of getting hit up by an explosive cast. That was almost too aggressive from Rush here. But all is well. Pink Ward's cleared, no objectives on the map available. Dragon is up, I take that back. But with Gate dead, nothing to be done yet. Recall by Phoenix does give time, though.
Well, honestly, they know Shockwave is down. So if they wanted to force the Dragon, it would be very easy. They don't even need Rush there.
They also have this Pink Ward that's been there forever since Rush took his first venture into Team Liquid territory. And the Pink Ward lets them know the dual lane from Team Liquid up on top. So the Dragon is free. And that's that neutral objective control they're looking for. Starting it off a bit late, but
yeah,
it will be there.
We're looking at minimum 39 minutes for Dragon 5, if that was ever going to be the goal. Never really gotten that far in these series, but always something to keep in mind. Last time in this competition, Impulse found nothing to do all game except to play for Dragons.
They keep running into the wall that is the secondary turrets. Yes, the outer ones are very easy for them to take down, and then they have a lot of more room to play with and get their picks. But Team Liquid consistently going back to the turtle strategy around the secondary line of turrets.
Something they're very good at.
Them out, waiting for that mistake.
This time, though, Team Impulse has brought an extraordinary amount of initiation. Even so, Dominate's able to get the blue buff away. Obviously, we just mentioned the Dragon was just taken, so there's not much to force Team Liquid outside of the blue buff. If Team Liquid wants, you would think they could hold this, unless Team Impulse is willing to dive the secondary tier of turrets.
In fact, losing a lot of health. He knows he has no teammates around here, but knows Quas can't do enough damage to kill him. Also, a rush on the Righteous Glory here for Impact. First item. Wants to get into these battles as fast as possible. Abyssal Scepter second for Rush. Nice hook in by Quas. Still cannot kill off Impact. He keeps healing through that passive.
Yeah. Just holding out, really. This is nice to see, at least from an item perspective. Everyone on Team Impulse has the same mindset this game of going full-on dive. Righteous Glory just continues with that. Gate has also started split pushing with the Nashor suit instead of sticking around in the mid lane. Since the mid lane turret is down, they're giving supportive help with Ash and Adrian so they can cover with more wards.
And the entire team can collapse into the mid lane where the Ash arrow and the Leona ult is there to set up the battles for Impulse.
Ooh. Yeah, that is the big difference this game, the double teleport for Impulse. And you have to keep track of these wards. You see the ward in the upper right corner of your screen right there. These stray wards deep in the lanes are going to be very important, especially on the side lanes where Impulse are going to be split pushing. The fights break out just like this because Gate does have his teleport available. He can join as well.
Oh, Rush nearly gets bursted down but stays alive just in time with the ulti. The stun's coming around. The damage comes through. Gate teleports in. And that's another one
for
nothing for
Impulse.
Exactly
what they want. Fight to break out on the sideline where they're split pushing. They can use the double teleport and Impulse get another kill away from turrets.
Yep, that's the biggest thing. Rush baited quite well with his ultimate. He's got a lot of resist there with the Abyssal Scepter and he hit two people with it. So we got a big shield right as Gate comes in. Nice collapse once again by Team Impulse. When Team Impulse is at their best, they collapse faster than any other team in North America, and that's one of the things that happened there.
And I really like the coordination, too. I don't know personally how to play well with the double teleport team, but they've managed to only use one TP for almost all these fights, and it was exactly the right number of teleports. Impact held his. He didn't try to show up to that battle. It worked cleanly.
Well, yeah. Impact was already at the battle.
Oh, there you go.
He showed up.
Easy.
Yeah, he was there.
What a difficult call.
Honestly, the stun right there from Adrian Solar Flare was so critical in also making sure Rush stayed alive. He has been really on point with Solar Flare this game. Team Liquid will really have to hold the turtle, even with all the things that Team Impulse has been doing. It's still just 3,000 gold, and they still haven't cracked the inner turtle.
That's true. All right, well, a lot of comfort back for Impulse, though. The Leona that was played so much in the spring split for Impulse as well. It's funny just to see how much they've gone back to. Piglet also back in Lucian. That was so important back when they fought Cloud9 in spring. He actually did very well in the champion back then. This time around, though, 0-2, not having a great start for the traditionally strong laning champion. Down 30 CS under Apollo. His bot lane tier 2 under fire. The perennial split push from Impulse is slowly cracking these turrets down. Liquid have traditionally been able just to wait on an overstep by Impulse and come back through that. And so far, the dives are actually very much succeeding. Oh, ew. And Piglet's going for Yomu second.
Take it, you're not a fan.
I hate it. Actually, I talked to Forgiven about it too. He hates it too. Just not enough damage in this champion.
Here we are again. Impact gonna be the one to run away once again. All right, well, let's see if Team Liquid decide to make any sort of move outside their comfort zone here. They've got some of the defensive wards up, not nearly as good as they've been in the last few games, and Impulse are looking to punish them for it. They're coming for the steal just a little too late. They deny it from Piglet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Dom's had to smite the buff itself twice in a row now, the blue buff that he wanted to give the Phoenix, the red now to Piglet. So the pressure, even though it's not taking the buff specifically, is still making an impact. Impulse finding other things to push for. If they're not getting tier 2 towards, at least they're going for buffs. At least they're finding things to do. There's another camp taken away. They're actually leeching a lot of the map away from Liquid here.
Yeah, they're definitely trying to. The unfortunate thing is when they have invaded the blue and red buffs, they have still been secured by Team Liquid. So while they are attempting these plays, the overall rewards have been minimal. Dragon stacking is probably going to be pretty critical here, as it's the one of the few ways they can get Team Liquid to come out of the base. Another big thing that Team Impulse needs to do is probably set up some deep wards now that we're post 20 minutes on the Baron side of the map, and just create opportunities to find picks. That's really all they need to do. Not necessarily a setup team fight against Gragas Jana where they could be disengaged, but the small skirmishes where they can get one or two kills and then just snowball that pressure and keep transitioning it into more and more objectives. But obviously those things take time. Team Impulse got the early game lead, and now they're waiting a bit for their mid game lead.
I'm actually surprised they haven't tried to set up for the Dragon.
Yeah, it's up right now. You would expect them to be all over that, because that's one of the big ways they have a win condition in this game.
Team Liquid already said they want to take top lane for a Dragon. That's why they sent their jungler, their top laner, their jungler AD carrying support onto the side.
Impulse want mid lane for it, though.
They're going to find Phoenix. Nice flash by Apollo. Hits the turret. Oh, no!
Get him!
Nice fine. Gets him anyway.
It's fine.
He's just trying to take that also.
Head start on the turret.
Objective focus free.
Yeah, objective focus. AD carries hit turrets.
This is big, though, because now the collapse is coming from Quas. He's hoping to get some help from the rest of his team, but he's so alone.
He's got no people around him. Top lane didn't even go down. Impact TP to a minion, but nothing picked up here. Trade of abilities.
Got to be honest. I was having flashbacks of the last series where Team Liquid and Quas versus TSM, you walked through the entire team and it cost them the game. This time he does get all the way through.
Yeah.
And he saves the tower some health, but there is that dragon. It should be free.
Really smart by Impulse, though, to go mid. We see so many trades. So yeah, top lane for dragon, top lane for dragon. It's like very repetitive, very normal. Impulse say, we'll dragon eventually. We're going to go crush your mid lane where Phoenix is here 1v3. By the way, we have Ash Arrow, so you're dead. And then they get dragon afterwards, and top lane didn't even go down. They forced Liquid to react to them.
Yeah. They burn to cleanse early, but then they can still slow him afterwards. I like the flash by Apollo. And also Rush having the headiness to keep the turret on him while Apollo flashed through, so it wasn't a chance of a return kill.
Rush didn't flash. Come on, man.
Apollo. He just got shockwaved.
Yeah,
Rush got shockwaved and stayed.
I'm saying Rush. Why wasn't he up there with the same speed?
He didn't need it. He was aware of the power.
Summoner spell discipline, Kobe.
Yeah.
Oh,
see, another fight. They're just trying to force him. This one, they don't have a big numbers advantage. They could match teleports. This could be a 5v5,
though. Remember, Zen, the flash on the Piglet. Here comes the teleport from Quaslo. All five will be here. Adrian's running. Impact's still holding the front line. The shockwave catches quite a few, though. And maybe the front line goes down. Rush is already dead. Gate flashed out. But the hook onto Apollo means they turn in, and they pick off the AD carry. Piglet gets himself a kill. Adrian's going to be the next one going down. A 3-for-0, and they're not done. Team Liquid want blood. Dominate gets himself the fourth kill of the
fight. Baron too.
And they Baron's can move the right over to it. They still got special with plenty of mana. He can lend shielding to Quas, who is a massive tank.
Yeah, that is exactly the type of 5v5 fight that Team Liquid couldn't even dream of. They got to disengage with multiple spells. Gate, oh, he's trying to be a hero.
Gets one. He's got the shields. It resets. Oh, he can't quite get him, but it buys enough time. Team Liquid can no longer take Baron. That's perfect.
Woo. All right, successful hero move. For the most part, maybe he could have got to, but being able to close X special while saving his Lunar Rush was huge. Need to see that fight again. The one fight Team Impulse, this is the first time they haven't had a big numbers advantage, and they also start by taking a fair bit of damage. The Nautilus teleport can be matched by that Diana teleport at the start of this fight.
Yeah, Nautilus actually channels it first, and Quas arrives, so they corner Rush, and with the exhaust, Rush gets nothing off. Remember, he is a big part of the damage in this team, so Rush down first, Team Liquid then are able to turn the tides.
Yeah, also the fact that Quas was able to single out Apollo because the tank line was in the retreat and Apollo was a little bit late on that memo. Really good hook by Quas on the tail end of the fight.
What brings us back to a 2,000 gold game. Team Liquid are a game away from at least being the number one seed in the North American Regional. Stun hits Piglet, though. He's got nowhere to go. The shields come through, flashes.
No, he's alive.
And he somehow stays alive. Somehow he gets out of it.
Shields on shield.
Yeah. Shield as he's shockwaving away just in case someone's fallen. But even so, Team Impulse is trying to push this pressure advantage. Phoenix does have good wave clear.
The push in towards mid-tier two. The fight keeps going
again.
In, though. They want this. There's no way to carry for either side now. The battle continues. The turret's still alive. Gate did kill Phoenix one for one, but these guys are still stuck under the turret. A nice pull in by Gate to buy some more time, but he's got not enough damage to deal anymore. It's a 2-for-1. They're going to keep going. Impact got nothing else to do in this battle. Gets continually rooted and stunned and slowed down, but he finally walks away.
Oh my, he's gone.
And in comes Piglet. The re-engage is not going to mean enough. Impact will go down. Another team fight one for Team Liquid.
Quas again with the hook under turret.
We don't necessarily have time for a break, though. X-Special got a full channel Monsoon off, and they are 4v2. They're going to pressure the Baron yet again.
They're under teleport, so the two guys that are dead cannot rejoin except for using their legs. Here's the four-man push, the hook onto Adrian. He is tanky, though. That's
all a distraction.
People.
They took a lot of damage from Baron here.
Yeah, Dom can't tank this forever. That makes them run away, but Adrian is likely to be the sacrifice here. They push on in. Down he goes. Phoenix rejoins the team. Five alive, but Dominate is low.
Team Liquid took the bait, though, so there's no time to finish that Baron.
But now this is a tied game.
Yep. Fight after fight is now going to Team Liquid. They've been able to get some decent disengages off or put Team Impulse into not the greatest fights. I mean, Apollo is pretty low when this one starts. Another great hook by Quas makes it so Apollo has to go into retreat instead of DPSing out of the turret. It really delays the beginning of this fight. And then Tip needs to cut their losses right here. It's a bunch of meatballs and a Janna underneath the turret. These are low-value kills, and they take a long time. The turret basically kills Gate and allows Team Liquid to turn the
They're
fight.
Low-value kills that are really hard to get away from because they constantly snare you. And Team Liquid, again, that was a 4v5 under the turret, only made possible by taking Apollo out at the very beginning.
That's the kind of play run hook champions. Get behind your teammates, but he was off to the right-hand side. And he was laid bare, available, and Quas finds another hero hook, 0, 1, and 9. That is a really, really strong play from this top end here of Team Liquid today.
Yeah.
Throughout these playoffs as well, we just saw Apollo get hit by a couple Nautilus hooks. In the TS, in the series they had against CLG, Apollo, he was put in positions where he needed to carry with his Kog'Maw, protected by the Lulu, and he was consistently taking a lot of damage before fights or had some poor positioning within the fight. Trying to make the adjustment to be more of a carry threat with Xiao Xiao out of the picture and Gate as a more supportive mid laner has not been smooth. And now in this case, where he's actually in a position of something more familiar, where Gate is on a damage dealer, he's still having some positional mistakes. That Zhonya's, he's still CC'd during the duration. He's getting clocked on.
Yeah, still buys a lot of time, and they're gonna put him right in the sights of Piglet here. Gates got nowhere to go. There's the slows. Gets taken down. Piglet's on a rampage from 0-2-0 to 4-2-4. And yet again, Team Liquid find the better fight in the mid game.
Yeah, it was looking like Team Impulse was going to be able to force a game five easy with how well they were making those dives happen. But the inner turrets for Team Liquid still stand, not able to be taken down. And even the dragon now that has respawned is very contestable. 10 seconds on gate before he spawns. He does have teleport to join. This could be a giant fight.
Zeke's done as well on Xpecial, so it's going to be a really scary
Rush
Piglet.
Is behind. He has perfect position for the start of this fight.
They
can also
here's
teleport
the TP.
In.
They're going in the Ash. Stun misses. Rush is exhausted. He runs back. Gate impact.
Double
Homeguard
TP. Two Homeguard TPs, and that doesn't start the initiation. It's a bad fight for Tip
they
to take.
They jump across. Blue team picks up Dragon that was smited, but Piglet finds time to hit Rush. He dodges the stun, but not the rest of the team. Adrian dies in. Piglet's dead. That's huge. The fight continues. Xpecial is next. This battle's being won by Impulse as Impact still takes the front line. He finally goes down, and here comes the re-engage. Apollo, yet again, found by Quas. 3-2. Liquid wins it.
What a close fight. It's almost certainly going to be four, but it's going to take them a little while to run down Adrian. Two Homeguard TPs burned at the same time. Adrian, nice try.
He needs to delay as long as he can, though.
Yeah, and he did. It stops any other objectives from being taken.
Yeah, Team Liquid, they can still try and get over to Baron first and start clearing wards and lay down the preparation for the next bait, because that is the next neutral objective on the map that will be pulling people out. Being the first there to set up your vision is actually very big. They need to get on that quickly. Dragon down. It was taken by Rush.
Yeah. Both Homeguard TPs used as the arrow whiffs. All the initiation that Team Impulse would want for a super clean initiation, about three quarters of it missed. So when they go in for the dragon fight, it is just a straight up brawl with no big advantages at the start. Luckily for Team Impulse, though, the ultimate does hit tanks and gate, and then Rush is able to single out Piglet. Adrian, if they didn't get the Piglet kill, it was a clean ace.
Yeah, eventually, Team Impulse just walk around Quas. They realize that there's no point in pouring damage into him. And since Piglet dashed over the wall into the dragon pit, they're able to punish him for it.
Yeah, if I was Quas, I would almost try and build some type of magic penetration or something, because he's being so heavily ignored. And it's really just the tanks who are winning the day here for Team Liquid. It's the shields, everything is being focused onto the back line. So when inevitably the tanks are alive at the end of the fight, it's important that they can do some DPS.
The thing is, they've already got the Abyssal Scepter built, and they've already got Locket as well.
Yeah, he's gonna continue to build tank for sure, actually.
It's Frozen Heart CDR, but...
Yep. I do like the Abyssal Scepter on Phoenix really heavily, though, as far as Gate trying to dive him. Having both the Athenes and the Abyssal Scepter for defensive capabilities makes him much harder to kill.
145 MR with the ball on him while near the Aegis. Good luck killing him. Certainly a durable Orianna in this one. We'll see what else Team Liquid can do, though. They are the ones now in control. Despite the Dragon Steel, Team Liquid now sitting pretty. 1,300 gold up. They've won fight after fight after fight. Impulse, actually... They have one persistent damage dealer in Ashe, and they have yet to really keep Apollo alive, whether it's his positioning or the front line holding strong.
Either AD carry is going to have a really, really hard time staying alive in these team fights. Lucian, such short range versus Maokai, Diana, you know, Leona here. Both of them are just going to be counting their days.
And Adrian going for a tankier build. He's the one going Aegis. It allows Rush to buy more durability. Has the pieces of Dead Man's Plate. I don't know if it's enabled in this version.
Oh, time for Rush to come in.
And he's going to try to turn around on a Quas. The pull back in. Now there's
Baron
no
They're pulling
left.
Baron off.
And that
Quas,
means they've got to run.
Quas also has TP advantage, so he can absolutely support this after. If it turns into a fight, it would be a 4v5 for Team Liquid.
Baron gets stopped, but now maybe a re-engage. Can they get their way in? There's the ulti coming
there's
across.
The
there's the pull, and Gate can't stop it. It's a 5v4. Quas gets stunned up. Shaka hits a few. Apollo knocked up as well. How good is the front line now? He gets unstunned. Impact going to be the first to die. He flashes, gets a heal, gets jumped on. He will die. It's a 1-0 so far.
Team Liquid able to take advantage of a very small window. The single teleport team with the extra cooldown here. And Quas is able to... Uh-oh. He comes back anyways.
Even so,
can they bait anymore?
No, they can't.
They can't. Got to clear out inside the Baron as well.
All right,
so even with all of that, great play down bottom to draw them across. They only got one kill out of it, and they have no idea there's this ward on the Baron.
It's going
so they're
going to
take a bunch of damage here.
Fast.
Yeah, but Impulse have been able to heal up and join.
Yeah, this is dangerous. No ult from Rush either. Gage is going in.
Baron doing a lot.
Dominate low, and Orianna still stuck in the pit. They might kill off Dom, but they've already killed off the Ashe. It's a trade 1-for-1, now a 2-for-1 in favor of Team Liquid. Dominates low, but these guys have to run away. Yet again, a fight won by the red team. Piglet's gonna find Gate. Oh, Gate burn the ulti to dodge away towards the minions. Piglet comes in, but here comes Impact. Is it gonna be enough? Diana putting in the damage. Piglet's alive! He's gonna stay up. The Locket Shield is there. Impact and Rush showing, but do they have the damage required? They do not. Piglet is still alive. He refuses to go down. Expecial is picked up, and now no one can stop Rush. Phoenix is dead. How about a wet noodle fight here in the top lane? Quas not taking damage, really. But Impact will heal thanks to Rush's low cooldowns. Dominate smites to heal. Puts the barrel across.
This is going to take assistance to peel
Apollo arrow.
Class.
He goes towards Piglet. He goes towards Piglet. Dominate saves his life. And Quas will slowly go down. He does not have teleport. That's a big shutdown. Piglet will need Homeguard to get back to this fight.
That was pure luck. They had no ward seeing the arrow shot.
Yeah, pure luck for Dominate. And that.
But it's not over!
Yeah,
what?
It delayed recalls. They're just going to try and parlay this straight into Baron. Their teleports are back, baby. They're going for Baron.
No Homeguards for the guys joining in. It's just Phoenix. They will not have Dominate. They will not have Piglet. There is so little chance of a steal.
Phoenix!
He's got it! Are you kidding me?
Team
Liquid steals the Baron.
What a heartbreaker for Team Impulse. Phoenix comes up big.
I mean, heartbreaker, backbreaker, series-ending play. Could be any of those things because now they can go straight for the Dragon and also stop the potential 5 Dragons from Tim. After that 3 to 4 minute chaos sequence where Team Impulse thought maybe finally they'd gotten back in the game. Nope. Phoenix stopped it.
Phoenix. Give that man a raise.
So what are we going to replay? They were like 4 minutes of action.
Let's replay the part where it was Nautilus versus Maokai.
Oh my god. All the aggression that happened that didn't happen in the last game is replaced by this game.
They get Expecial. He's going to die. Ulti pop. That's an extra ulti burn. Piglet dashed away. He pops the ult.
Back to the cannon.
All right, 5v4, it's gonna be harder to push, but they still wanna try.
Yeah, no Ash Arrow, no Leon ult. They still have Rush's ultimate if they really wanted to go, but they do have their carries up. It's just the Janna that is down.
Are they willing to fight?
They gotta go.
They're willing to fight. They're gonna look for
Quas.
He's very tanky.
He's under the
front line. Shockwave. Apollo goes down to the start of it. Gate goes down too. A 2-for-0 and a 4v5. Make that a 3-for-0. Now they're gonna get Impact. That's 4 kills picked up. The turret's next.
Phoenix, yet again, he lands a huge shockwave. This time it kills 3, and with the Baron buff up and 30 seconds on the 4 members of Team Impulse, this game could be over.
It could be just like game 1 right now, guys. One good fight, and they went for the game-ending push. This could be 3-1 for Team Liquid. 20 seconds on the respawn. They've got a wave. They've got Baron. They've got third place in their sights. Team Liquid take down turret number 1. They're going to get turret number 2. They're going to win the series. Team Liquid win third place over Team Impulse.
What is it with these guys and the game-changing Baron steals?
What an amazing ending to this series. After that incredible series of fights that lasted at least 4 minutes around the Baron pit, back and forth, tanks, meatballs, everything going on, Phoenix gets the one shockwave. It obliterates everything about Team Impulse, their chances in the game, the end of their season, their fourth place for sure. It just ended the game on that one play.
A hug share between former teammates Impact and Piglet. Certainly a well-fought game on all sides. Very worthy competitors here of the stage. We got 4 very different and very exciting games tonight.
Oh yeah,
we did. And there's Team Liquid. They earned it, 3-1. A well-deserved victory. The accolades from the fans and the audience.
Standing ovation from the sold-out crowd here in Madison Square Garden.
And this means that if TSM wins tomorrow, Liquid will go to their first ever world championship. And even if not, they are the first seed heading into the North American regionals.
The end of that game was just absolutely insane. You can see Team Liquid still processing what actually happened.
They are definitely tenacious. They, twice in a row, made the very correct call to go for a difficult situation. The fact that they went to go push the 4v5, their support got picked off, and they said, it's okay, we're ahead by enough, this will work out, and they were correct. In game one, narrowly picking up a couple of fights, grabbing the Baron, winning the game within 3 minutes. Risky choices that have definitely paid off here for Team Liquid.
Piglet and Impact have now gotten to play in front of the Staples Center crowd as well as the Madison Square Garden crowd. You could tell how important it was for Piglet when he walked out today that he have a good performance. Pulling out Lucian in the last game. Super elusive in the final fight down at the bottom lane. And it's an important match. As